A very good morning to everybody, and thank you for tuning in to the Bulletin on this beautiful Sunday morning, the 16th of June, 2024. You are listening to the club station of the Sandton Amateur Radio Club, 06 SDN, which is operated today from the shack of Angus, 06 Golf Oskarska. Once again, a warm welcome to everybody on frequency, and I trust that you've had a great weekend thus far. And secondly as well, to all the fathers out there, a very happy Father's Day. This bulletin is broadcast every Sunday at 8:45 local time on the following frequencies. 145.700 MHz FM on the 2-meter band. 7.115 MHz lower side band in the 40-meter band via the relay from the shack of Null ZR6DX. And then we have Echolink, ZS6SDN-R. In the bulletin today, club birthdays and club news, general ham radio news, and then special topics of interest. Let's start with some birthdays for the past week and the coming week for club members. Okay, for this last week, I have three. Firstly, on the 10th was Mike Barth, ZS6XYZ on the 10th. Then we've got it was Arno Miller, which was on the 13th, and then today was Adam Levine. I'm not sure of call signs, apologies on that. Then for the coming week, we've got two birthdays. We've got Debbie Skoltz, ZR6DEB on the 17th tomorrow, and then Mark Collum. I hope I got that right, on the 22nd, ZS6LEB. I hope you guys are going to have a good birthday, and if you did have your birthday, I hope it was a great one. Let's see if there's any club news. ZS6SDN is now listening.
ZS6HI,
good morning to you there, take a round.
Good morning, Angus. I'm pleased to be able to listen to the bulletin. I was on my way to Heidelberg, but that's been delayed a little while. So just to give you a little bit of club news, there are two articles in the news, the SARL news this morning from the club. The first is the Tech Talk, so listen up to that, and it will give you the Zoom link as well. So our own Brett Airy will be doing the Tech Talk the last Wednesday of the month, and he will be talking on Mesh-tastic and LoRa. So one to put into the diary, and please do dial in or connect on Zoom for that Tech Talk. Then there will also be, there's a heads up in the SARL bulletin regarding the forthcoming winter QRP QSO contest. So be aware of that as well. That happens on the 20th of July, and we would like as many, many people to participate in the winter QRP contest as possible, especially as this one is sponsored by the Sandton Amateur Radio Club. So those are the two articles in the SARL news. Last week, I announced that we would be having a fox hunt with a difference, and that's been delayed, so we're not going to have it this coming Wednesday. It was going to be on Wednesday the 19th, but we felt the timing was a little bit tight, so we will reschedule that to a future date, and we will let everybody know. And that is going to be a triangulation contest. So from what you need to do is collaborate with your buddies on the repeater or on 145.700 and to triangulate where the terrorist group is. So that'll be quite an interesting and fun activity coming up shortly, but we will keep the details under wraps and we'll let you know as soon as we've got a date in mind. I think those are the key highlights at the moment, Angus. ZS6SDN, ZS6HI.
ZS6HI from ZS6SDN. Keith, thank you very, very much for that news and that. Greatly appreciated there. Let me move on to the SRL bulletin. In the news today, two contests this afternoon. Club news and contest news. So stay tuned for these and other interesting news items. We begin the bulletin of news with the news of a silent key. It is with deep regret that the Bloemfontein Amateur Radio Club announces the key of Michael Falkey, ZR4 Watch went silent on Monday, the 16th of June 2024, after suffering a respiratory problem. Michael was active on the UHF and VHF frequencies. We extend our sincere condolences to his to Elrin ZR4 Echo family and friends. Okay, then there's two contests this afternoon. The first is the SRL Youth QSO is a fun activity to celebrate the youth and to promote contacts between young radio amateurs of Southern Africa countries. Calling CQ Youth, the first leg runs from 1200 to 1300 UTC this afternoon, Sunday the 16th of June. Youth Day with phone and CW activities on 40. The exchange is an RS or RST report and the operator's age. Youth stations in the RARU Region 1 are classified as age 26 and under. Submit your log sheets by 21:59 UTC on Friday the 21st of June 2024 by email to ZR3VDK@outlook.com and ZS3PA@outlook.com. Get the rules on page 55 of the 2024 Blue Book. Then, 17th of June is International QRP Day, and South Africa operators are invited to test their QRP skills this weekend. The Wacky 1W Challenge takes place between 1300 and 1600 UTC this afternoon, Sunday the 16th of June, and the aim is to test operators' knowledge of effective antennas and the operating procedures by limiting power levels and using distance to calculate the scores instead of the number of contacts you make. A 5-watt category, which is included to those whose radios cannot reach the 1 watt, results are grouped by power, category and mode, which creates the ideal opportunity for you to benchmark yourself against similar stations. For more information or to download the activity log sheet, visit the challenge website at www.tinyurl.com/wacky1w. Then, are your contact details correct? Kelly at the National NARC office reports that she's receiving numerous return to sender invoices and SRL communications emails. Check your email address and contact details are correct. Go to the records in the SRL call book, click update and fill in the updated contact details. Okay, club news. The affiliation of the West Coast Amateur Radio Club, ZS1 Whiskey Killer, has approved the council meetings on Tuesday, the 11th of June, 2024. The club is centered around Bredadale and the members right down to Hopefield and Jacobs Bay. The ZU9ZZZ 145.7375 MHz repeater can be accessed in the surrounding areas of Fredendal. Okay, then the Fur Trekkers annual Brandkapjol camp is taking place again from 22nd to 29th June at the T.O. Strand in Port Edward on the south coast of Natal. The campers can choose between courses such as scuba diving, snorkeling, paddle surfing, and rock and beach fishing. Felt identification and hiking, survival and self-preservation, photography and journalism, and oceanography. The ZS9BKJ station will be operated by Gerard, ZS6 Charlie Romeo Sierra, and the Yaga, ZS6 Zulu Oscar. The call sign is also registered educational call sign, and the youth members will be encouraged to get to know amateur radio. The technical problems experienced last year have been addressed and will will look forward to making as many contacts as possible. The station will all be active on 40 and the 2 meters. Okay. This month's Power Hour TikTok will be on Meshtastics and LoRa. What is Meshtastics? A new type of rice? Nope, looks like you need a clue. It is an open source, off-grid, decentralized mesh network built to run on affordable low-power devices using LoRa radios. Who or what is LoRa radio? Does it work? Does it work, and can you do it? What can you do with it? There is an article about Meshtastics radio on page 73 of the May 2024 issue of Radio ZS. Then, please join us for the Power Hour TikTok on Wednesday, the 26th of June 2024 at 1900 hours Central African time. Learn all about Meshtastics and LoRa. The TikTok will be hosted live by a special guest and resident guru, Brett Ashwell, ZS6, Mike India Victor, using Zoom, with the audio relays on 145.700 ZS6 SDN repeater. Echolink is ZS6 SDN-R, and connections and connected all-star modes. Do you have a pen and paper ready? Because here's the Zoom meeting ID. It's 845-9045-1304. And the password is 503-626. If you missed any of the details, the Zoom details, they are available on the SRL's event calendar and your favorite Facebook page. Everybody is welcome. So please spread the word and make sure you join us for the Power Hour TikTok for a collaboration and interactive learning experience on Wednesday, the 26th of June at 1900 hours Central African time. Then contest news. The 2024 RARU HF Championship takes place over 4 weekends in July. It begins at 1200 UTC on Saturday, the 13th of July, and runs to 11:59 on Sunday, the 14th of July. There is no operating time restrictions for stations or any categories. The aim of the contest is to support amateur self-training in radio communications, including improving amateur operating skills, conducting technical investigations and intercommunication with other amateurs around the world, especially IARU member society headquarters stations. Okay, the exchange is an RS or RST report and your ITU zone. For South Africa, Botswana, Namibia, Lesotho, and Eswatini, it is zone 57. Headquarter stations operated by the IARU National Society send the abbreviations for their societies instead of the zones, i.e., ZS9HQ. Send RS or RST reports stations operated by the IARU Administrative Council and the 3 IARU Regional Executive Committees. Send RST, AC, R1, R2, or 3 as appropriated. The SRL would like to put ZS9HQ on the air for the contest, and operators are required. The rules allow for an HQ station to have multiple stations using the same call sign on various bands and modes. Okay, so e.g. ZS9HQ on 10 meters CW and ZS9HQ 10 meters SSB. So ZS9HQ 15 meters CW and ZS9HQ 15 meters SSB down to ZS9HQ 160 meters CW. If you would like to operate the ZS9HQ during the contest, please contact Carl ZR6Killer at Carl, that's K-A-R-E-L, ZR6K at gmail.com. Are you getting cold yet? Well, not to worry. We have an event taking place shortly after the winter solstice. There will be a heat up the airwaves, winter QRP. This is a warning that you have only one month left to prepare and decide on your strategy for the winter QRP contest taking place on Saturday, the 20th of July, 2024, from 7:30 to 9:30 UTC. Many QRP contests have provided ideas to which the contest committee have listened. The last two legs of the year will include enhancements and include experiments, the report of the distance and the distance and power bonus. The longer the distance and or the lower the power, the bigger the benefit. This ultimate means that even the fairway stations have a significant chance to grab the top awards. Diarize now for the fun event and start planning on how to intend to beat Philip ZS6 Foxtrot Yankee, the current QRP top scorer contester, on how to intend to obtain a mode or top chaser award. The SRL QRP contest is a fun activity to promote QRP operation and experimentation. See the contest manual for all the details. Catch you on the air. Propagation report. Hannah Scotia, ZS6 Bravo Zulu Papa, reports the solar activity to expect it to be at low, moderate levels. There's currently 9 sunspot regions with simple to complex magnetic configurations visible. There is high probability of C and N-class flares. If you want to do your own frequency prediction, the effective sunspot number for the week is around about 124. The 10 to 30 meter bands, especially in the later afternoons and early evenings, provide some good DX fun. For more information, please visit the website spaceweather.sansa.org.za for further information. Then, just a diary of events. Today is Father's Day, Youth Day, the SRL QSO, Youth QSO Party, and the Wacky 1W Challenge. The 17th of June is Public Holiday and World QRP Day. 21st of June is the Winter Solstice at 20:50 Central African Time. And the closing date for the youth logs. 22nd of June is the Piers Fox Hunt at the Walner Scout Hall. 26th of June is the Santon Amateur Radio Club Power Hour Tech Talk. Then the 28th to the 30th of June is the Ham Radio in Friedenstor. I'm not even going to try and pronounce that. And then 29th and 30th is the ARL Field Day. All right, I'm going to move over to a special topic of interest. Obviously, what to say, there's quite a few of us who like building stuff and everything like it, even projects. And obviously a lot of us use the Arduinos. And I know they're nice, they're simple, they can do a lot of things. And my thought was, who actually made this? Anyway, so I went into a bit of a digging, and I came up with found something, and it's a brief history of the Arduino. In 2004, building upon the work of Hermando Brunander, creator of wiring, Massimo Banzo and David Koulos created Arduino, an easy-to-use programmable device for interactive art logo, art design project. At Interaction Design Institute of Ivana in Italy, David Metz developed the Arduino software, which was based on wiring. Before long, Giuliano Martino and Tom Igo joined the project, and the five known as the original founders of Arduino. They wanted a device that was simple, easy to connect to various things such as relays, motors, and sensors, and easy to program. It also needed to be inexpensive, as students and artists aren't known for having lots of spare cash. They selected the AVR family of 8-bit microcontrollers, MCU or UC devices from Amtel, and a design of self-contained circuitry board. With the easy-to-use connectors, bootloader firmware for the microcontroller, and packages all on a simple integrated development environment, the IDE, that uses programs such as Sketches, the result was the Arduino. Since then, the Arduino has grown into several different directions, with some versions getting smaller than the original and some are getting larger. Each has a specific intended niche to fill. The common element among all of them is the Arduino Runtime AVR-EGG library that is supplied with Arduino's development and environment, and the onboard bootloader firmware that comes preloaded on the microcontroller with every Arduino board. The Arduino family of boards uses processors developed by the Amtel Corporation of San Jose, California. The most of the Arduino designs utilizes the 8-bit AVR series of microcontrollers, with the due being that the primary exception with the ARM Cortex M3 32-bit controller. So that was just a bit of a history regarding it. I just found it was very interesting, and what I've seen so many things what these things can do. So that was just a bit of history regarding the Arduino. Thank you to everybody that's out there for listening. We trust that you've enjoyed the bulletin today. Feel free to give us comments or any constructive criticism. I thank you to the stations who've assisted with relays and broadcasting, and those who've contributed content from time to time. Join us again next Sunday morning at 8:45 Central African Time for the regular bulletin of the Santon Amateur Radio Club. This brings a close to the weekly club bulletin of the Santon Amateur Radio Club, ZS6STN. ZS6STN was operated today by ZS6 Golf Oscar Oscar. Once again, thank you to all the listeners and 7 threes. ZS6STN now relinquishes all frequencies for general use.